Всем привет! Меня зовут Юля, and today we are going to learn another verb of motion. Well, actually, two of them. In English it is to go, and in Russian we have two verbs: ехать, ездить. In my last video we talked about the verb to go, but in the meaning on foot, yes, to go on foot. Идти, ходить. And today we are going to talk about the verb to go, but only by vehicle. Okay, so на машине, на метро, на поезде, на велосипеде, на мотоцикле. So any type of transportation on the ground, not plane and not ship. Not yet. Any transportation that is moving on the ground. Okay? So, in Russian, ехать и ездить. So, firstly, let's conjugate these verbs. Я еду, ты едешь, он едет, мы едем, вы едете, они едут. The verb ездить, conjugation. Я езжу, ты ездишь, он ездит, мы ездим, вы ездите, они ездят. And probably you remember that here it is very important to pay attention to the direction, if it is one direction, or back and forth, or multiple directions. Step by step, let's compare these sentences. First one. Я еду на работу. If you say я еду на работу, I'm going to work, the first thing I understand that you are using transportation. You're not going on foot, no. Я еду на работу, it means that you are using a car, train, bike, somehow you are moving, but not on foot, okay? We can precise, я еду на работу на машине, I'm going to work by car, but up to you, it's not necessary. Я еду на работу, it means also that the action is happening right now, that this is you, this is your job, and you are going to your work. Yes, this is you, this is your work, and you are moving towards your office or your place of work. But you can precise, it's not necessary, but you can precise. Я сейчас еду на работу. But even if you don't say сейчас, we will understand that the action is probably happening right now. For example, somebody is calling you and asking you, what are you doing? And you say, я еду на работу. This is the case. So usually we use this type of verbs with сейчас when there is just one direction. It is possible to use the verb ездить when the action is happening right now if there are multiple destinations. And the typical example is я езжу по магазинам. Again, the first thing that we understand if you say я езжу по магазинам is that you are using any type of transportation, metro, car, bike, we don't know, but not on foot. You can precise, я езжу по магазинам на велосипеде, for example. And the second thing, why we use this verb, because I gave you last time the same example, this is, I don't know, a city, or this is, yeah, for example, this is the city, and there are different shops. So you're not going to one particular shop. You are moving to this shop, then this shop, then this shop, and etc. And everything by car or using any type of transportation. Okay? Я езжу по магазинам. And And you can add, if you want, сейчас, я сейчас езжу по магазинам. And also you can add type of transportation if you think it is necessary. So one more time, if the action is happening right now, pay attention to these arrows. If it is just one direction, you have one destination, it is ехать. If there are several destinations, I know it is a little bit confusing, we use the verb ездить. Then we use ехать for future actions, for future events. Again, if there is one direction and probably it is not a habit. For example, этим летом мы едем на море. So you see that it is present tense, but this summer we are going to the seaside. So it is, we use it for future events in like a future tense, because this is the seaside, and we just going to the seaside. Here we, it's clear that it's not a habit. No, we don't do it every summer. Not a habit. Not a habit, one direction, the verb ехать. Этим летом мы едем на море. If you want to say that every summer we are going to the seaside, this is a habit. This is something that you always do, never do, once a year, every weekend, etc. We use this type of verbs. For example, каждое лето мы ездим на море. So you will see каждое лето, every summer. This is a habit. So we use ездить. Every summer we go to the seaside. So the typical situation, for example, каждое лето мы ездим на море. It's a habit. Но этим летом мы едем в горы. So this is not a habit. This is just one time situation. So we use this type of verb that usually we go to the seaside, but this summer we will go to mountains, okay? For the habit ездить, one time situation, also because it is, it has one direction, we use the verb ехать. Past tense. Он ехал, оно ехало, она ехала, мы ехали. For example, вчера я ехал в кино и неожиданно пошел дождь. Yes? So it was me, this was the cinema, and when I was moving, when I was going to the cinema, towards the cinema, suddenly it started to rain. Вчера я ехал в кино. So this is this situation. Ездить, past tense. Он ездил, оно ездило, она ездила, они ездили. And we use, again, with habits, that something in the past happened regularly. Never, once a year, sometimes, etc. It was a habit. В прошлом году я каждые выходные ездила на дачу. So last year, every weekends, I went to dacha. Dacha, it's a typical countryside house. So usually people live in the city center, and on the weekends, they go to dacha. So here, two reasons why I used the verb ездить. Because it was a habit in the past. В прошлом году я каждые выходные, it's a habit. And ездила на дачу, it means that I went to dacha, but I came back. I didn't stay there. Yes? So there are this back and forth movement. While here, we say clearly that we are talking about this way. We are not talking about way back home. No, we want to stress that On the way to the cinema, it started to rain. Когда я ехала в кино, пошел дождь. Okay? And imperative. Two verbs for both verbs. Ехать и ездить. Only two forms. Поезжай. If you address to one person and it's casual way. Поезжай. Поезжайте, if you address to several people or you want to be polite. So this is ты, this is вы. Поезжай, поезжайте. Okay? And I know that it might be confusing still that we have two types of verb for just one verb to go. That's why I propose you to do some exercises and practice a little bit more. Practice time. So let's do this exercise, fill in the gaps with the verbs ехать или ездить to check your understanding. And also I think I forgot to mention some points, so we are going to talk about it as well. So, sentence number one. Обычно они на работу на машине, но сегодня они на такси. So in the end, the first indicator, обычно, shows us that it's a habit. So when it is a habit, it's ездит. So let's conjugate. Обычно они ездят. Обычно они ездят на работу на машине, но сегодня они на такси. So, сегодня, today they are going on by taxi. So, it's an exception and it is just this part, yes, from point A to point B. And it's not a habit. Но сегодня они едут. Они едут на такси. Next sentence and it's a dialogue. Куда ты? Та-та-там. Я в бассейн. Как часто ты в бассейн? Я в бассейн каждую субботу. So, somebody is calling you and asking, куда ты едешь? Exactly, куда ты едешь? Because the action is happening right now and the person is asking, where are you moving from point A to point B? Куда ты едешь? Я, so we use the same type of verb when we answer the question. Я еду в бассейн. Я еду в бассейн. And then he asks you, как часто ты в бассейн? How often do you go to swimming pool? How often? Here we see that the person asks you about your habit. Yes? How often do you go there? That's why we need to use this verb. Как часто ты ездишь в бассейн? Как часто ты ездишь в бассейн? And we use the same type of verbs because we are talking about our habit. Yes, каждую субботу, every Saturday. Я езжу в бассейн каждую субботу. Я езжу в бассейн каждую субботу. And here I'd like again to pay your attention that verbs of motion plus our destination, it is accusative case. We ask the question, как часто ты ездишь куда в бассейн? This is accusative case. В прошлом году мы в Германию. So yes, indeed, it's not a habit, but it is back and forth. We didn't just went to Germany, we came back. So for facts about our past, when we have two directions back and forth, we use this verb. В прошлом году мы ездили в Германию. Мы ездили в Германию, past tense, because в прошлом году, last year. Next one. Я люблю в горы. I like to go to mountains. And when we say that we like to do something or we don't like to do something, we use this type of verb. And in my previous video for идти, ходить, I mentioned it. For these verbs, I didn't. That's why I put this example to remind you that we like or we don't like to do something, this verb. Я люблю ездить в горы. В горы. Я люблю ездить в горы. And we conjugate the verb любить. That's why next one is in infinitive. Я люблю ездить в горы. Завтра мы в театр. А что будешь делать ты? Tomorrow we are going to theater. And what are you going to do? So this is just our plan. This is us and this is theater. So tomorrow we will go to theater. And it's not a habit, it's not something that we do every weekend. Yes, there is no information about it. So this is this type of verb, ехать. Завтра мы едем в театр. Едем в театр. And last sentence. Он не умеет та-та-та, на велосипеде. Mm-hmm. When we are talking about our abilities, if we can or cannot do something, this is also this type of verb. So, он не умеет ездить на велосипеде. Okay, so, yes, these were two points that I forget to mention, that ездить, this type of verb we use when we like or don't like to do something, or that we can or cannot do something. For example, он не умеет ездить на велосипеде. He cannot ride a bicycle, yes? Or я люблю ездить в горы. I like to go to mountains. What else? That's it. So again, with verbs of motion, pay attention to the direction. Then pay attention if it's a habit or if it's just one-time situation. Okay? Let me know if you have any questions. I know that verbs of motion are very tricky and difficult for most learners, but slowly, I promise you, we are going to master them. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.